Elizabeth and Mary, although they never got on in life, are buried side by side. Your hearts. Elizabeth is the only one to be honoured with an effigy on her tomb, because Mary was not a popular woman. Come to the throne of England through Elizabeth, one of the first things he did was to make sure that she got a very splendid tomb. Innocence Corner. First and foremost, in here, we've nearly all heard of the Princess of the Tower, or Princess in the Tower, who should have been King Edward. It was Prince Edward and Prince Richard. Plantagenet, and they're said to have been murdered by their uncle, King Richard III. Their bones were discovered underneath a staircase in the Tower of London in the reign of King Charles II. And that King Charles II had those bones moved here in a lavish ceremony. And this is what we're looking at. In the Latin, it kind of translates as they were most villainously murdered by their uncle Richard. But many now doubt that theory. And don't think that Richard had them murdered. Many think that it was the lady we've just seen in the other video, Margaret Beaufort, my lady, the king's mother. Because Richard, if he had them murdered, his reputation, he knew it would be destroyed, which it was. Even then, they didn't like child murderers. But yeah, a lot of people say that Margaret Beaufort had them murdered to pave the way for Henry VII, which it kind of did, because her husband, Lord Hastings, he had access to the tower at the time. That's the princess in the tower. Sophia Regia. This is daughter of King James. And if you look in the mirror, you can see the reverse of the tomb, which is a baby in its crib. It's very sad. Pseudonames. As I've been saying in my documentary, she courted the love of her people and knew how to do that, and knew that if she did that, she would be a successful queen. I do sometimes wish that I was taller. Dragon and the Lion of England. stove rings. An awful lot in the reign of Queen Mary.
So
King James thought that he'd have them buried side by side in the hope that they'd settle their differences in death. The differences they'd had in life, so as two queens and two sisters buried side by side at the feet of their great uncles, Edward, who should have been king, and Richard, his brother. So yeah, there's a pretty messed up dynasty, the Plantagenets, the Tudors, the Wars of the Roses. But what ended the Wars of the Roses is the marriage of the next couple we're going to see in our next video. So join me inside the main body of the Lady Chapel for that. We'll have to be quiet there. Was the husband of Mary, Queen of Scots, who she had murdered. Which wasn't very kind, was it? There is the tomb of Mary, Queen of Scots, which we're going to go and see now. Scots was executed, she was quietly buried. When her son James I came to the throne, he had his mother moved into the prominent position. So his mother and his father are more or less together. Bearing in mind that the mother murdered the father, it's a bit of a funny situation, that one. This is Margaret Beaufort. Son King Henry VII, whose Battle of Bosworth Field is what put the Tudors on the throne. Margaret Beaufort here was married very, very young, ridiculously young, to Jasper Tudor. And she had Henry VII, well, she was pregnant when she was 12, and had King Henry VII when she was 13. And they say that such a young childhood labour ruined her inside, and she never bore children again, although she was married several times afterwards. Tudor died of plague. My lady, the king's mother here, got to see her son come to the throne. There aren't many lifelike or any real full traits of Margaret Beaufort from when she was alive.
Sorry.
From when she was alive. But, sorry. When she was alive. Just some that were painted afterwards, like as her likeness. But the face that you've just seen on the tomb is very likely done from a death mask. So you've just looked and are going to look again on the face of Margaret Beaufort, my lady, the king's mother. She died just a few days after the birthday of her grandson, King Henry VIII. She'd seen her son come to the throne. He died fairly young, had a reign that was never knew a moment's peace. Then he died, and she died very shortly after her son. They say from a broken heart, from losing her son. And then Henry VIII came to the throne. After a couple of days after his 18th birthday, she died. Since you know, the dynasty was secure. Henry Lord Darnley, look. Henry's second son to this lady was King of Scots and father to James VI, now King. This Henry was murdered at the age of 21 years. Charles, her youngest son, was Earl of Lennox, father to the Lady Arabel. He died at the age of 21 years and is here entombed. So here you've got Henry Lord Darnley with the crown above him. He was blown up, or they tried to blow him up, and he got out of the window and they found him strangled. Lord Bothwell was responsible for that one, I'm afraid. So, and inscriptions everywhere here. Margaret Douglas. See, they had royal connections, Margaret Douglas. And her son, Lord Darnley, wanted to marry Mary, Queen of Scots, and Queen Elizabeth III, Queen Elizabeth I forbade it. But he just was a man of his own mind and ignored the Queen, went to Scotland, married Mary, Queen of Scots, which turned out to be the worst decision that they both ever made. Because he ended up being blown up and then strangled. And she ended up a prisoner and then being executed in England. And the execution of Mary Queen of Scots, whose tomb we can see there, is really what sparked off the Great Armada of England.
Thank you.